Jellyfish have sunk.
Jellyfish have sunk.
Fishing trawler.
With their sheer weight and mass.
By pulling them down in their nets.
By pulling them down in their nets.
Jellyfish proliferation in polluted waters. Nasty subject. I see I have two viewers. That's nice. Nice to have somebody watching. These security fellows are probably the supervisors. We had a little mild run-in with them before. Over the definition of a monopod as opposed to a tripod, but they backed down on that one. So one of them seemed to have a bit of a brain, whereas the other one had none.
Yeah. brewed you. Make sure you vote for me.
So here we are together, wandering through the crowd. Liberty. Here in the depths of New York City. Horrible depths of the Wall Street area. Drum circle goes on.
Thank you.
study on crowd dynamics in this place. One moment there's a clear spot, and the next minute it's overflowing with people. And no matter where you go, you're blocking some cameraman from his shot. And there's an awful lot of cameras here. Incredible amount of recording being done. In case you see someone doing an interview, just to give you an example, that seems to be, claims to be the New York Post, although I wasn't aware that they did videos. You see, you stop and all of a sudden people are walking around you and ducking. And it's really crowded here right now.
Usually how it is.
Not easy to get around. But that's good. That means we have a wonderful turnout. Quite a few people who might actually learn something they didn't know today. Defeats King Capital. We can only hope. actually happened. We shall see. Oh, I'm not real pleased with Mr. Obama. I have to say that in my personal opinion, somewhat biased opinion, Mr. Romney is not the man to lead this country, except further into debt, etc. Oh, here we go. This sounds fun. Infamous tax dodgers. Infamous and amusing. Infamous and amusing. Oh, that's an interesting way to put it. Trinity Place and Liberty Park. Not quite so many police down this end, or more tourists, less occupiers, fewer occupiers. But we can see we're well covered down here. And plenty of tourists checking us out, wandering by, including those who are not bothering to look at us very much, but crowd like this draws the eye. Particularly out of towners might actually find out something they didn't know, which would be really cool. Getting the word out to everybody. NBC. Their dish. Yet again, he went down. We can only hope that he goes down later. Later this fall. Apologize for any grumpiness I expressed earlier on my part. Didn't get enough sleep. Tired. That long march last night. Probably should have skipped, but I felt I ought to do something. Here's one of our favorites right there. Stop Motion Solo himself.
How are you doing?
Just fine. How are you, sir? Good, good. Oh, it's quite a handy gadget. Stick my iPhone in there. Works like a charm. Whole thing like helps balance when I'm walking so it doesn't shake too much. Drop the stick down and rest it. They weren't going to let me bring it in before. They said, you can't touch the ground with that. They didn't know the difference between a monopod and a tripod.
No, I'm from Dragon 170 around.
Oh, well, that's another trip altogether. This is the handy-dandy way to be a citizen journalist.
Yeah.
Certainly. I need to get up over the cloud. I got I've enjoyed it ever since I got it. It works really good. Yeah, well, that's my battery is packed and extra wires and such. What's that?
I'll give you a story. There's a specific point for 1% in fact Wall Street CEO demonstrated
please feel free to keep that. I have lots of them. Oops. They're killing cats.
Another Scott.
That's all right. I have to say, it played well. I love the pipe.
Yeah, you had the edge or something sticking out.
Yeah, getting a little sloppy here near the end of the day.
Sam.
Mac.
All right. Top floor up there is the office of George Anderson. George is bad driving.
Okay.
January 2008. George runs Enterprise Engineering, which owns a product that's used for a lot of front end transaction work, particularly on the
right.
I don't know how much George played around.
Nah.
But he was drunk. He'd come out late. He came. He took an old hospital. He admitted everything.
Uh-huh.
With 16 and days in the pipers and
fantasy. Okay.
Which is nothing but the prosecutor's office advertising the table on sale.
I see. This is an interesting story.
Welcome to New York.
Yes, yes.
A new flow. So this thing got started.
Uh-huh.
The guys called me saying, right under George's window.
Right. Yep. That's good.
You hit her and kept going. Hit the line.
Uh-huh. I hear you. Oh, dear. There's always something else. I don't know how to look. There's always something else.
I'm going to look for this thing.
You didn't get a whole hell of a lot more ingredients than that.
I'm telling you. That's. These people don't have much in the way of morals, I find, but, or they can. Their morals can be bought.
Whatever.
Yeah, 2BigLounge.com.
Uh-huh.
First one is about $35 billion. That's from Michael Wolf.
Uh-huh.
Explain the scam. And they did it again. About $100 billion.
Uh-huh.
$30 billion.
Uh-huh.
Mortgage thing is really the same thing.
Yeah. Yep. I hear you.
Same people, same.
Yep.
5.2 trillion.
This is gonna be a long fight, I guess.
You're gonna watch?
Nah.
Welcome to Rome.
That's all right. I was out there in the 60s. That took a long time, too. Pretty good. Nah, I'm sure. I mean, if it's bad, you know. I hang out in a group, recreated some Middle Ages, and I've heard bad pipes.
My relatives in Canada, every damn one of them owns one of them.
There you go. I thought it might be fun to get a chanter and see if I could play it at all. But even now that I quit smoking, it takes a lot of air. Constantly puffing, I fear I'd have to.
I like the little Irish
thing. Anyone, but yeah, doesn't he?
Oh, wow.
Doesn't he? Absolutely. The trouble with the bagpipes is you really don't want to have to learn it. You want to be good right away. It's a pain while you're learning. I've done a little bit of that on the violin. So far, I'm still paying for
it. Well, he seems really to know what he's doing.
Yeah. No, he's good.
Yep.
be a 7-year piker. She's really good. Hoping a fucking blow them capitalists down.
God damn.
I know amongst pipers, it's felt that to be a really proper piper, you need to play for 7 years. And this fellow sounds like what they call a 7-year piper. But I'm not an expert at the pipes. But that was damn fine. That was really good. Gotta appreciate that. Quiet, so can't really make it out. Oh, sorry for swinging you around there. I was trying to reinsert the hole. No matter how I say that, it sounds weird.
How'd the course go last night?
It was very tiring.
I believe you.
We were late getting here today.
Me too.
Yeah.
I screwed up my charger. I said, I don't want to have to wait 20 minutes over a door for a train. I'll grab a quick beer. I missed my fast train. I missed my other train. I spent an hour and a half at Newark Express.
I've been there.
I know. I heard your ordeal.
Yep. So, yeah.
The fast train.
It's like,
that's how you guys got the room, right?
They,
so you got to deal with it. Anyway.
That's right. This time, anyway.
Where is he from?
North Jersey, by Rockaway, Denville. Yeah.
DHA country.
Yeah. Exactly. Absolutely.
It's a good show place to go.
It's nice there. It's reasonably nice, I have to say. Man, nice crowd, I gotta say.
Yeah, what's your estimate?
Beg your pardon?
What's your estimate of crowd size?
I'm not good at that.
1,500, 2,000, something like that?
Certainly, throughout the time I've been here, probably that many people have been here. I don't know if they're all staying all the time. We get a lot of tourists traveling through and taking pictures.
Yeah, but I mean, there's more on the outside.
But yes, there are.
So you don't count the ones on the outside.
And of course, we definitely, there's other venues which have a lot of people, so... You know, we're out there today.
Hundreds, 500.
Yeah,
and that four fans up. Well, 1,500.
I can believe it. It's a reasonable turnout.
So, were you here last night for the Rosh Hashanah too?
Yeah, that's when we got here.
Uh-huh.
We did the Rosh Hashanah and then we did the march.
That was pretty interesting for my first time.
Yeah, it was,
taken or whatever,
we were just late enough getting here that I couldn't get really close, you know. But I filmed a bunch of it and then, wandered around too, you know. I do both.
Right.
I try to represent the people watching by wandering around like they might, you know.
Right.
Yeah, especially because half the time I don't know what's going on.
You got a picture of the styrofoam concrete barriers?
Nice.
He says OWS on them. Protecting people from the powerful.
Yeah.
It was pretty good.
That's a good one. No, I missed that. I like that.
Yeah, some of them, they're carrying on full dollies. They had like two stacks, three highs. So there's at least six of them. They're going to set up a little barricade somewhere. Who knows?
Yep.
It's pretty innovative, I thought.
Yeah, really. Oh, that's right. The rumor was they were going to have some barricades up today. In fact, the rumor was we weren't going to be able to get into the 2 blocks of here.
They just like having those rumors out
there
trying to discourage people.
Pace University was telling their kids that there was going to be checkpoints. I got off at Trinity. Wouldn't you think they'd have a checkpoint there? You know, so. I think they backed off a little bit. But, I heard there were a bunch of rest.
Something going on over there.
See, you never know when something's about to go on. They were carrying one of those blocks, though. You never know. Looked like it was made out of foam. One guy was carrying it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They're strong.
Very powerful,
strong.
Very powerful.
Our strength is in numbers, not
that's a fact. Oh, man. Love that old camera that guy's got there.
Oh, he wants to take a birthday portrait. Get everybody on the steps.
That's like a new old camera. That looks nice.
That's for a lithograph.
Yeah. It looks really cool. I mean, that's okay sometimes, just to look cool, yeah.
It's for that Occupy Noir look.
Right. Although, it's New York, so...
Right, he might be here every weekend or something.
It's hard to tell unless we're yelling about something. Right. I mean, I feel so conservative in this outfit, yeah.
Well, you're pressed.
That's part of it. I want to at least look at it.
You want to film the rest, not get them.
Precisely. On the nose.
I heard they got angry fascists today. I didn't see what.
Did they get him? I know he was going to try to get arrested.
All right. Well, then he succeeded.
But I don't know if he was ready yet.
Right, I'm not sure how that works either. You know?
Yeah, he was going to go over to the Freedom Cage, he said, and be arrested there. But. I don't know. I haven't seen him yet today, so maybe went ahead and did it.
I read that around 10 o'clock online.
Okay, all right.
Or 11 o'clock, I got it.
All right, see, that's, I missed all the morning activities. I was going to be here, and then I couldn't wake up. I got kicked about 10 in the morning. I was like, oh, fuck, yeah.
All right, well, I got home at 2. I got up before 10, but groggy as hell, you know.
Yeah.
My buddy gave me his laptop, and I tried getting the Ustream on there, but it was way too slow. Or else they were blocking, or whatever it was.
I never know. Also, there's, like, pockets, there's dead pockets around.
Right.
There's one right up by that corner there. When I was walking this way, I lost the connection, got it back. You know, so.
I saw somebody on social media.
So, but it's great to see all the streamers out here, I must say.
Well, they said this morning it was like 22 guys out, so I didn't feel that guilty about myself.
Right.
I wanted to be here, but
they just covered. Some mainstream. We have 30-second clips on the major news.
We'll get something.
Last night at 11 o'clock, there's something at the bar. They had a formation of Occupy. I thought they were going to say, no, I just came from there. They're just not recording. You know?
Yeah.
Actually, the camps are gone, but not the spirit, right, not
exactly.
The people.
Now we occupy the mind. We're trying to occupy the mind of America. We don't have to occupy geography.
It was such a good idea. I don't know why they ever gave it up. So, well, we didn't. That's why they're putting the kibosh on it, because it's too good of an idea.
And we're unarmed, that's why.
We're armed only with our wits.
That's right, you know. We're not interested in battles.
And a sense of integrity.
Yeah, absolutely. So, absolutely legitimate fight for our rights. Yeah. Hey, brother, I'm going to wander around a little bit more.
Go on.
Good seeing you. Good to talk to you again. Thinking pink here. Okay, folks, I'm going to do a quick save.